Nia Vanessa.
Okay, could you ask her what life was like underneath the occupation and how it is now for her?
كيف كانت الحياة وقت كانوا موجودين المسلحين وكيف هلا؟
نحن كنا طلعانين
طلعنا. أمتى طلعتوا يعني؟
طلعنا صار لنا 5 سنين.
They weren't actually under the terrorists. They have.
So they're coming home.
They're coming back. They're coming
so
back.
So she was in West Aleppo and she's coming back.
وين كنتي عايشة بحلب الغربية؟
من بيتنا من حيدارية.
يعني بحلب الغربية؟
لا هون حيدارية.
وقت تركتوا طلعتوا وين عشتوا؟
من الأبطال الجيش أخذ الصناعة بركنا المدينة الصناعية حلب الشيخ نجار.
They stayed in the industrial zone in
Sheikh Najjar.
Najjar. Yes,
okay.
Yes.
And what was life like there? Because that was also occupied.
No, they actually lived there after the liberation of Sheikh Najjar.
Okay, all right. And she had family here in East Aleppo.
كان في عندك عائلة بحلب الشرقية؟
طلعنا من دخل الإرهاب.
They left since the terrorist
okay.
entered.
Okay, so
they
how
left.
Is it to come home to her
كيف
home here?
شعورك وانتو راجعين تسكنوا هون بالبيت يعني؟
كويس الحمد لله.
Very good.
أنا عندي
very
جامعة
good.
تهددوني
لأنه. She has her children are studying in the university, so
in Aleppo University.
In Aleppo University, okay. So she was threatened, so she left. And then her sons actually joined the army to fight against her.
How many sons does she have?
كم عندك ولد؟
عندي
4.
4.
4 and they are all in the army.
كلهم بالجيش؟
2 بالجامعة.
2 بالجامعة.
2 at the university and 2 at the army.
تمام. شكراً.
شكراً.
Could we ask the kids?
الله يحيي الجيش.
الله يحيي
الجيش. ثوريني ويخلي الجيش.
God protect the army and protect Bashar al-Assad and Syria too. And stay in our home. This is her husband. And their house was destroyed by the terrorist. You want to talk to the kids?
Yeah.
Okay.
Can the kids tell me what it was like? Did they live here under the occupation?
ولا رجعتوا لهو؟ يعني كان في حدا منكم عايش هون وقت كانوا موجودين المسلحين؟
انا كنت عايش
هون؟ He lived here where when the terrorists were here.
Could he tell us what it was like?
كيف كانت العيشه؟
الحياه صعبه يعني شبه مستحيله.
It was difficult, almost impossible to live.
ارهاب.
Terrorism.
حرمونا بلقمه العيش.
They didn't give us food actually.
بشوف الغلط قدامك ما بتستجي تفتح تمك.
And if you see anything going wrong you cannot say anything about it.
سرقت املاك الدوله والاملاك الخاصه امام عيوننا.
They were looting public and private things.
اذا هذا حرام او ما بيصير.
And if you object to the looting,
أنت وطني يجب تصفيتك يعني مباشرة يعني.
If you object to the looting, then they anyone who objects to the looting, they are sentenced to be killed.
Okay. And did they receive any medical treatments?
كانوا يعالجوكم ولا لا علاج طبي أو شيء؟
في مشافي بتروح بتتعالج فيها بس كان دواء تركي ما بينفع يعني مثل ما أقول. والكادر الطبي الموجود اللي يعالج المدنيات غير اختصاصيين يعني.
There were some hospitals but sometimes you go there you get treated but mostly the medicine there was Turkish and it wasn't good and the people working in the hospitals are not professional doctors.
Okay. And was there any sign of a civil defense or the white helmets?
كنتوا تشوفوا شيء اسمه الدفاع المدني او القبعات البيضاء؟
اللي تابع لهم؟ بيشوفوا الوقت اللي بيصير مثلا ضرب او كذا كذا بيجوا بيشيلوا ركام شغلات الجرحى يطلعوهم من هذا ويكون في تحت المسلحين يعني مثل ما يقولوا يضربوا عصفورين بحجره.
We used to see some of them here, but only when there were like attacks on the armed groups. So they come and take the armed groups actually from under the rebels.
So they didn't help civilians.
يعني ما كانوا يساعدوا المدنيين، كانوا يساعدوا المسلحين.
المسلح بالدرجة الأولى. المدني.
Armed groups first priority. First priority. Civilians second priority.
Okay. And did he witness any atrocities committed by the terrorists?
شفت شيء مثلا مجازر عملوها المسلحين؟
أنا ما شفت بس اللي سمعناه وقت الدولة فتحت معابر آمنة مشان يخرج المدنية.
He didn't see, but what he heard when when the government opened safe exits for people to go.
فقاموا يضربوا على المدنية.
The terrorists started shooting at the civilians.
Yeah. طلعت مظاهرات ضدهم.
And because of that, people actually organized demonstrations against them here.
كمشوا الرجال وقاموا يعذبوهم.
They arrested the men and started torturing them.
ومنعونا من الخروج بأي شكل.
And they stopped them from leaving by any means.
So they arrested, they took the protesters and they tortured the protesters.
Yes. يعني أخذوا اللي كانوا يتظاهروا وعذبوه.
How does he feel about the Western media portraying the Syrian Arab army as being the perpetrators of these kind of atrocities?
كيف شعورك إنه الإعلام الغربي عم بيقول إنه الجيش هو اللي عمل هالشيء ما المسلحين؟
نحن أنا صار لي 6 سنوات هون بالمدينة ما طلعت برات المدينة.
I said I've been here for 6 years inside this city. I haven't left this city.
فأنا شفت كل شيء وعانيت من كل شيء.
I've witnessed everything and I have suffered from everything.
فلما ندخل الجيش هون على المساكن ونحن خرجنا من أحيانا من حيدرية وطلعنا لعند الجيش والتجأنا كان الحكي غير عن اللي يروجونا إياه.
When the Syrian army actually came to Hanano and we came to the Syrian army, it was totally different from what they used to tell us.
فكانوا يقولون لنا ميليشيات شيعية ذبح قص رغبة كذا غيره.
They used to tell us inside the يعني يقولوا لكم كانوا المسلحين.
المسلحين.
The armed groups used to tell us that there are Shia militias that will slaughter you.
بلدك ما تم.
And now the no more Syrian army, only Shia militias.
فلما اجينا وشفنا الواقع لاحظنا اولاد بلدنا قاموا يقدمون لنا اكلهم لنا نحن كنا جائعين. وكانوا مستودعات موجودة بتكفي حلب سنة بس بحيين ها بتكفي حلب سنة كانوا بيعطونا بس 6 خبزات وخبز خالي.
And when we came to the Syrian army actually provided us with their food. Although you have to know that there was two food storage houses that actually sufficient for 1 year for Aleppo. Yet the terrorists only give us 6 خبزات.
6 خبزات صغار.
6 loaves of bread. 6 little loaves of bread.
يوم أي يوم لا.
Every other day.
قمنا نطبخ على المي. ما بنحط سمنة ولا زيت. كانوا كل شيء كيمشينو.
Yeah, they actually controlled everything. We didn't have oil or butter to cook.
وكل شهرين بيعطونا نص حصة غذائية. وطلع من استودعات كفي حلب.
And each 2 months they give us some food. And then we found out that they owned food storages that are sufficient for all Aleppo.
And how does he feel now?
كيف شعورك هلا هون؟
والله ما بيتغدى. شيء عظيم.
It's priceless. It's very great.
أول شغل الإنسان حس بالأمان.
The first thing that we felt safety and freedom.
يعني بتحسن تحكي ما بتتحاسب.
We can say whatever we want here. We can.
إني أول ما طلعوا شو نادوا إني حرية.
The armed groups actually the first thing they called for is freedom.
فأي مسلح إذا تنتقده أو كذا مصيرك
الموت. But if you criticize any one of them actually they will kill you.
وين الحرية؟
Where is the freedom about in this? Okay.
شكرا
كثير.